Handicapper Steve here, handicapping the racing from Aqueduct Racetrack here on Sunday. It is the 29th of November 2020. Good luck the stakes races on the program from the Big A, but before I get on to that, remember to please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingHit5 for more selections for race courses around the world. Let's look at the stakes action races 7, 8, and 9. The 7th race, it's the Autumn Day Stakes, purse $100,000 race for fillies, mares, 3-year-olds, and upwards. We have a field here of 16 or 15 horses entered. 11's an AE, 12 through 14 are MTOs. Only 10 could go to the outer turf course, the distance of ground of 1,200 meters, or the distance of ground of 6 furlongs on the Aqueduct outer turf course. 1,200 meters, 6 furlongs, rails at 36 feet, so the rails are basically at the middle of the turf course, and you know, they're going to be some very tight turns. Who would have thought, like, but about 10 years ago, if you would have said to somebody, oh yeah, 10 years from now, the inner dirt track at Aqueduct's going to be a turf course, and with portable rails up, you're going to have even tighter turns, because that was the running joke about Aqueduct's inner dirt, the tight turns. Even tighter turns today, so you need to have good position. I think you have to have some forwardly pace. And with that being said, I'm going to go with the 8 horse Madeline Must. We'll go 8-7-10-2 in the superfecta, 8-7-10-2 super. Tops looking 8 horse Madeline Must. This 4-year-old filly here by Motivator. Christophe Clement trains. Junior Alvarado gets the mount. The horse's most recent outing came the 14th of November here at Aqueduct, yielding turf course, 6 furlongs and ops 62. And the horse won by a neck and had a great stalking position. He stalked, got the lead, and then he just took it off to a very nice, easy victory. Second off the bench, that was a very good race. First off the bench on the 20th of September at Belmont, 6 furlongs firm ground, ops 62. He finished second by 3 1/4 lengths. The winner, Lee Guitar, just ran a very good race on the front end, going away with this. But this horse just kind of stalked, moved up a little bit that day. I didn't think it was a half-bad race off the bench. And then prior to that, he ran the 5th of July at Belmont, 1 mile of the Widener in Opsal 62. The horse finished 4th by length. And I don't know if the horse liked the 1 mile trip, kind of just plodding along, never quickening up there. And then the North America debut on the 4th of June at Belmont, 7 furlongs off 62. Like I said, I don't think the horse liked the trip, and also the first off the bench, the horse need the race, finishing 6 by 4 and 3/4 lengths. Like I said, need the race. Looking over the races from Europe, the better races have been run on a turf course that has a slight give in it, which you'll see today. Also, the races with a sprinting trip, the horse runs a lot better. 9-2 here today, training well. Let's take him. So to recap my selection for the 7th from Aqueduct, it's the Autumn Days. Let's take the 8 horse Madeline Must. We'll go 8-7-10-2 in the superfecta. The featured 8th race now from the Big A. It is the Fall Highway Handicap. It's a grade 3 event going for a purse of $100,000, races for 3-year-olds and upwards. We have a field of 7 horses going to the main track, the distance of ground of 1,200 meters, or the distance of ground of 6 furlongs here in the Fall Highway. 1,200 meters, 6 furlongs. My top selection, we're going to go take the number 5 horse here, who is Share the Ride. We'll go 5-4-6-3 in the superfecta, 5-4-6-3 super. Top selection, the 5 horse, Share the Ride, co-high weight here, carrying 133 pounds. This 5-year-old gun by City Candy Ride, Antonio Arriaga trains this one. Jose Ortiz gets the mount. The horse's most recent outing came the 18th of November at Parks, 7 furlongs and a allowance race, 51,000. The horse did everything right there, winning by 7.5 lengths. He stalked, he got the lead, and just basically it was a paid workout, a 1-1 buyer. Great run. A few weeks earlier, on the 31st of October, in a local prep race for this race, 7 furlongs in the Bold Ruler Handicap, he finished second by a head there, and he set the pace. Majestic Dunhill got to this horse late, but he still ran his heart out there, going 7/8, and then prior to that, Belmont, 6 furlongs in the Vosburgh, he finished third by 4 lengths. He set the pace, but then he got caught by Friend's Fire. But, you know, he showed some heart that day against a very tough competition, and then before then, the Mr. Prospector at Monmouth, 6 furlongs, September the 12th, winning by 3 3/4 lengths on the front and all throughout, just kept going. A 109 flat for that 6 furlongs and a career best 103 buyer. That was an all around good effort there. You know, since moving to the new connections back in August, or July, August, whatever it was, he's been really becoming a great horse, and he's been running on basically no breaks. You know, he's been running every other week, it seems. He's doing nicely. 9-5, let's take him. So to recap my selection for the 8th from Aqueduct, it's the grade 3 Fall High Weight Handicap. Let's take the 5 horse, Share the Ride. We'll go 5-4-6-3 in the superfecta. The 9th race from Aqueduct, I believe this is the final turf stakes race of the year, if I'm not mistaken. I can't remember next week's stakes schedule, but the 9th race from Aqueduct, it's the Tevin Stakes, purse $100,000, race for 2-year-old fillies. We have a field of 12 horses entered. The 6 and 8 are MTOs, so only 10 can go to the inner turf course. The distance of ground is 16 or 1,700 meters, or the mile 116 trip on the aqueduct. Inner turf course, 1,700 meters, mile 116th. Rails at 0 feet on the inner. My top selection here, I'm going to go take the number 4 horse, Invisible Gal. We'll go 4-2-3-8 in the superfecta. 4-2-3-8 super. Top selection of 4 horse, Invisible Gal. Two are fully by Invisible Spirit. Grand Motion trains. Jose Ortiz gets the mount. The horse is most recent out and came at Keeneland on the 6th of November, 1 mile. And the Breeders' Cup Filly Mayor, Breeders' Cup Filly's turf. And the horse finished 11 by 7 lengths and basically lost all chances at the draw on that previous Monday. Drawn 14 of 14, didn't break that well, was way out of it, moved a little bit late, but, you know, the horse has to be drawn a lot better. Drawn better here today, lesser quality horses. I think this horse should really romp. This is your free space in the multi-race wager today, I think. Two back in the Sleem at Pimlico, yielding ground a mile 16, 3rd of October, and the horse finished 2nd by 2.25 lengths. Kind of stalked all the way around the race course, had the lead, but then Fluffy Socks got to this horse late, who I believe then went on to win yesterday at Del Mar, so won two in a row. But this horse ran a very good race behind Fluffy Socks that day. Wasn't nothing bad about that run. And then before then, the Sorority at Monmouth, 1 mile, September the 7th. The horse finished 2nd by a half length and didn't break that well. You know, a little trouble trip, closed up from nowhere. For all said and done, for this horse to nearly win by a half, almost by a half length, you know, nearly win. I thought it was a very good effort. And then before that, Saratoga, 5.5 on the Mellon in main special weight, 72,000. Horse won by a half length again, was a little bit wide and got there in the nick of time. Even though this horse isn't a sprinter, she's going to be basically a good miler, I think. In the mile trip here today, 2-1, like I said, free space in your multi-race wager. So to recap my selection for the 9th from Aqueduct, it's the 10 pin stakes. Let's take the 4 horse Invisible Gal. We'll go 4-2-3-8 in superfecta. So good luck to all. Please follow me on Twitter at horseracingkid5. Good luck, everybody.